Hello, everybody. I'm Burns Hargis, and welcome to another edition of Inside OSU. This edition is in the newest building on the Oklahoma State campus and the only one of its kind in the United States. The building known as Endeavor is literally transforming education, innovation, and design at Oklahoma State. This three-story, 72,000-square-foot facility opened in September of 2018. It's located on Hester Street, right next to Boone Pickens Stadium on the OSU campus. Endeavor cost $35 million, and half of that came from corporate and individual donors who want to help Oklahoma State acquire and develop top-tier students. Paul TIKALSKY is the Dean of the College of Engineering, Architecture, and Technology.
We went all across the country and looked at engineering laboratories and engineering facilities across the, from California to Carnegie Mellon, and we took all their great ideas and added some more, and then we built this. And the uniqueness about this is that it's only for undergraduates. This entire building has no dean's office or faculty offices or even graduate research space. It's all about undergraduate research, undergraduate learning, entrepreneurship, innovation. Every single bit of this 72,000 square feet is about the undergraduates pushing forward on the things they want to learn.
And you're not envisioning it as just engineering undergraduates.
No, right? In fact, the interdisciplinary projects and the entrepreneurship we're doing here, we're working with the Riata Center and any student on campus who wants to join in with the engineering and architecture students and invent their own future. They can do it here.
You really move from the theory to the applied pretty quickly.
That's right. So we've really moved toward an interdisciplinary, hands-on education that this tool, this building, provides us with that. And so FSB, which is an architect that was selected for it, and Flintco Construction, worked with specialty architects as well who work on special labs like this to design a facility that you can see in every single room. There's glass everywhere. You have utilities that are strung in such a way that you can change out the lab and make it something completely different from semester to semester. We have the opportunity to do just about any kind of advanced manufacturing of computer components or circuitry or 3D printing in metal or carbon fiber. All of that's right here, and it's for undergraduates to do as they choose.
And equipment-wise, lab equipment-wise, it's really cutting edge as well.
We partnered with National Instruments and Shimatsu. And Shimatsu is one of the leading manufacturers of kind of Cadillac test machines in the world. And National Instruments is the platform by which many industries provide data acquisition, data management, and the electronics by which we choose to do the Internet of Things, as it would be. So they actually talked to each other as well before they provided their respective gifts. But there's more than $2 million worth of that kind of equipment in the building. And then another about $5 million worth of state-of-the-art equipment. All of it connects to National Instruments, LabVIEW, and this structure by which students can have their roommates watching their experiment on a camera in their dorm.
So this Elvis 3,
yeah,
and we're not talking about the singer here.
Nope.
We really are the pilot testing ground for National Instruments.
Absolutely. We had to
explain what Elvis is.
Sure. Elvis is, if you think about an electronics laboratory or an electrical engineering lab, it usually has 20 or 30 instruments at each station. And this Elvis 3 is a board, a breadboard, but it can also be transferred into other types of devices. And all of those instruments are compacted into something the size of a notebook computer. And you can choose what you want to look at, and you can look at thousands of things while the circuitry is being built.
It can measure anything.
It can measure anything. It provides power to it. It provides the type of power you want. So if you want sinusoidal power, or you just want DC power, or whatever you want, it can do it for you. You can even build a little crane on top of the board and make mechanical devices on top of it.
So, and then you're testing and proving this up for NI, and then I take it they'll go into full manufacture.
So the first 60 that exist in the world are here in Endeavor. They'll be here for the next year. They're getting feedback from the students on what we, in fact, they were here yesterday, and we got feedback from them. They're getting feedback from the students. And then NI will be adding additional components as our students come up with crazy ways to use this device. And in fact, they already came up with some new ways in which we're going to add new boards to it as well. So you're going to be able to do a lot more with it. Then they'll go to a more commercial level to the rest of the country.
What professions does Endeavor prepare students for?
We start with engineering, of course. So you have chemical, mechanical, aerospace, electrical, computer engineering, civil engineers, but also our engineering technology students in mechanical and electronics engineering technologies, fire protection. All of these majors are here, but also students from around campus. I think it helps the business students who come in here and get involved with with our entrepreneurial. Anybody on campus, whether you're from human sciences or education, if you have a great idea, you can make this building part of your education.
There are 20 laboratories in Endeavor. Each is designed to provide an unparalleled hands-on learning experience for our students. We stop by the Chesapeake Energy Flow Lab, where students learn about fluid mechanics. Dr. Dan Fisher leads our mechanical and aerospace engineering department.
At a very practical level, this lab brings together students from every engineering discipline to engage with and experience the phenomena we call fluid mechanics. The planes won't fly, the bioreactors won't react, the air conditioning systems won't heat and cool unless our students understand the phenomena that we teach in this lab.
So the purpose is to get them ready to go into industry?
The purpose really is to inspire our students to create and innovate. That's why this lab is front and center in this building, right? The Wright brothers, they gazed up into the ocean of air and were inspired to actually go out and build a wind tunnel.
So this is actually applicable to a lot of the things that we take for granted.
Lot of things, just about everything. You can hardly solve an engineering problem or get to that next step in technology without engaging with fluid mechanics.
Now, we talked to Dean TIKALSKY about how unique this place is. Is this a unique instrument for undergraduate students to work with?
Yes. There's actually two, I would say, research-grade instruments in this room. The flume right behind us here, and then the wind tunnel, which is right next to us, we're going to see in a little bit. And very, very few undergraduates, I would say, in the country get to engage with facilities like this.
So what does this tell me? The water's coming down, it's running along horizontally, and then it comes up all of a sudden. Is that?
This is the flume is designed to engage them with open channel flow, what we call open channel flow. And so you can see, really visualize here the kind of mysterious mechanics of this phenomenon. So they go to the classroom, they study the equations, but they can come and see it here in action.
It's easy to see the changes in water flow, but when it comes to airflow, seeing the scientific processes play out can be a challenge. Thanks to this wind tunnel, students can watch and measure the impact airflow has on the object in real time.
So basically, the subsonic wind tunnel produces a very streamlined stream of air in the test section that students can come in and put any model of interest inside of it to study maybe drag force and all the behaviors of the stream of the air around the model.
And how it behaves.
Exactly.
How the plane behaves as a result.
Mm-hmm. The forces, the everything in action. Yep.
So it can really accurately reflect what happens up in the sky.
Yes, sir.
Has this kind of changed your learning pattern by being able to have this kind of hands-on
Oh yeah, definitely. It's really cool because whenever we're seeing it in person, you can see how when you manipulate specific variables, you get the direct results and you're seeing how it changes the recordings that is going into the computer. So it's really cool to get that hands-on experience instead of just reading it from a textbook.
As Dean TIKALSKY mentioned earlier, Endeavor is for all our undergraduate students. Reagan Black and IBRAHIM ASAD are both seniors studying chemical engineering. They are among the first to get to study in Endeavor. We met them in the Valero Process and Transport Lab. Reagan, what science are you able to do in this lab?
So around the perimeter, we have all of the chemical engineering apparatuses that we use. So we have things that you would find in industry. Everything is mostly to scale, and then you'd actually find these as you go into your career. You'd have the experience already of working with these kinds of things. So this is our two-phase flow apparatus, and we actually already have this set up to get started. So if you want, I can go ahead.
Okay.
And kind of what this is meant to simulate or to demonstrate, how two different types of fluids, in this case, air and water, will interact with one another when they flow through a tube.
Why do you need to know that?
So this is something that commonly occurs in different industries. So in chemical industries, oil and gas, pharmaceuticals, you'll have locations where through pipes you have different sets of flow, and you want to see how pressure is affected by the speeds of different fluids. So if water is going really fast and air is going really slow, what happens to the pipes and things like that?
Yeah. Well, I just got to ask you, what was it like the first time you walked in this building?
So it was exciting, you know, being able to walk in here with all the new equipment and then knowing that we're going to be able to participate in all the different engineering experiments with fellow engineers from different disciplines.
As you can see, Endeavor is a testament to OSU's commitment to excellence and discovery. To learn more, go to ceat.okstate.edu/endeavor. And we'll see you next time on Inside OSU.